What happened?
Science isn't about equations and memorizing numbers and memorizing facts. You have to do a little bit of that. It's really about how can I use these tools to help us solve the problems in this world and to have fun while doing it.
Pennsylvania College of Technology added fun and flavor to the recent USA Science and Engineering Festival in Washington, D.C. Culinary arts faculty and students served a taste of technology at the nation's largest celebration of STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math.
We have been crushed. We've had 5, 6, 7 rows deep, and it's people are laughing, giggling, and you'll see Penn College chef hats that we give out to the children everywhere on the convention floor. It's fantastic.
More than 300,000 people spent 3 days experiencing hands-on exhibits, demonstrations, and science celebrities at the event, geared to inspire the next generation of STEM professionals.
There are less people choosing to study these disciplines in college, and so that's why we really believe that we need to start early, even as early as kindergarten, to get kids interested. We need to grow the STEM pipeline, but we also need to ensure that it's a diverse pipeline.
The people going into STEM don't really reflect our population. You don't see enough African Americans, you just don't see enough Hispanic Americans, and you definitely don't see enough women. Now that's important because we need to solve these tough technical problems, and if we're only tapping into a small part of our population, we're not going to solve the tough challenges ahead of us.
STEM jobs are projected to grow faster than average for all occupations during the next several years, but according to the Department of Education, only 16% of high school seniors are interested in pursuing STEM careers.
There, the laser beams are slowing them down so much.
We need to be thinking about how we get more kids interested in science and engineering so that we do have a homegrown workforce, because we can't always count on the rest of the world bailing us out.
What inspires one student to go into STEM might not be the same thing that inspires another student. So we need to really expose students to a variety of ways that you can apply a science or an engineering degree.
Step number 4, you step back.
You got a few seconds to present something, but the important thing is to connect that excitement to science so that when science comes up later in their life, they'll remember that and they'll be like, oh yeah, science can be pretty exciting.
At the Penn College exhibit, science can also taste good. Students employ chocolate to help guests discover nanoreceptors, and they combine liquid and sodium alginate with a chloride bath to create edible shells with orange soda centers. The reverse process yielded yogurt raviolis.
Our students, it gives them a chance to work with people of all ages. They're able to take the knowledge, practice the technique, and let the participants come through and actually recreate some of the techniques.
We're actually using what we're learning, so it's kind of twofold. You're actually not only gaining the knowledge, but you're able to reciprocate it to younger generations, so you're teaching and learning at the same time, so it's really, really worthwhile.
The biggest question that we get is, can we eat this? Like, is it safe to eat? And when they tell you, they're like, oh, it's so cool. Like, because they walk around, they see all the science stuff, and now they see some science that they can, like, experience, they can taste, they can feel.
They could feel a chill, compliments of liquid nitrogen.
We have liquid nitrogen boiling at right around negative 320 degrees Fahrenheit. We can then freeze Teddy Grahams, freeze marshmallows, even freezing the whipped cream and making instant ice cream, instantaneously getting really small, fine water molecules frozen together. That helps preserve the flavors.
Because it's so cold, the steam that you have in your mouth turns into a vapor. As you're exhaling, you almost look like a dragon. It's definitely an exciting time for Penn College.
Thanks to the college and other exhibitors, it's also an exciting time for STEM.
When I got out, I can apply that science and engineering background to anything.
Those that study STEM are really at the front lines of solving the world's greatest challenges.
To me, the most important thing I can say to a kid is stick with it. You belong. I'm waiting for you to grow up and be a scientist. You better hurry up.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.
Okay.